I just eating straight out of the jar, it really freaks my boyfriend out. Like, he cannot, like, it just, yeah.
Mabel, this is a very exciting day because we're going to play a game called Sorry Not Sorry. Are you ready?
I'm very ready.
I'm going to give you a little rundown of what it is. It's basically all those weird guilty pleasure things in your life that you should be sorry for, but you're not. You're not.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm not sorry. I'm just going to say that now.
What fashion trend did you take part in that you are absolutely not sorry about?
Ooh, wow, so many. where do we begin? Okay, probably like the super low jeans. Remember the that were like
low just rise,
like low
on
low,
the cusp
low
of
rise, which I kind of feel like is coming back now. Is it coming back?
Oh, without a doubt. But there's no way I will ever wear them.
I mean, I might try. I mean, I don't know.
There's nothing that's going on this without it being over my belly button.
I remember like my mum.
Christina Aguilera, Britney.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. I remember my mum being like, no, no. No, 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 no.
Were they comfortable?
No.
I feel like I'd constantly feel my downstairs was going
to
fall out.
No, it's really uncomfortable because your zip's like, I mean, it's like here.
Oh, you got to be careful when you go to the loo. How do you walk in them? That's the thing.
No, I don't think actually that it looked great, but I was convinced at the time.
No, it was a very good fashion trend.
It was.
I like that you're not sorry for that as well.
I'm not sorry.
You were bold and bright and beautiful doing a thing that you wanted to do, you know?
Right. I also remember wearing them with a Avril Lavigne t-shirt that she'd signed that somehow my mum had got, and I would literally wear it every day, and I'd tie it up and wear it with jeans.
Yeah.
And my mum was just like, I don't know what's going on here.
You were just like, mom, just leave me alone.
Shout outs to Avril's comeback though.
Shout outs to Avril in general.
Wow.
Yeah, she's nailing it.
Absolutely nailing it. Love her.
Sorry, not sorry for Avril Lavigne.
Yeah, no, seriously, not sorry.
Is there a TV show you're binging right now that you have zero regrets about?
I watch The Real Housewives of Salt Lake City.
I've just started watching that.
So I've watched Salt Lake City, Beverly Hills, New York. I've watched Orange County, Dallas, Melbourne.
I didn't even know that there's so many places in the world.
I've watched all of Atlanta being the best one.
Yeah.
Atlanta goes off, but we're in between seasons right now. We're waiting for a new one.
To be honest, it sounds like a good way to spend your time.
I spend so many hours in glam though. People are always like, how do you watch all this TV? But I spend so many hours in the chair.
Yeah.
It's that mindless kind of numbing TV.
100%.
Like, I read
it doesn't matter if you miss 10 minutes of it, because really it's all just the same thing.
I read somewhere the other day, it's like you need to be careful about like what your brain's consuming or whatever. And I'm just like, but I'm not sorry.
No, I'm not sorry.
I'm not sorry. It makes me feel good.
What weird habit, past and present, past or present, are you sorry but not really sorry for?
Ooh. Mm. Okay. I listen to Harry Potter read by Stephen Fry every single night when I go to bed.
So do I.
And every single night.
What's your favourite?
Difficult. I think maybe Goblet of Fire.
That's my favourite. Too exciting to sleep to though.
Or Prisoner of Azkaban, because Sirius Black is my favourite character, and that's
such
when he comes
character.
In. Oh, Sirius.
Shout out Stephen Fry as well. You nailed those seven books.
All the characters, every single character hits me in my soul. Like, but obviously, you know, when somebody's sleeping next to you,
they have to
also listen to Stephen
Isn't
Fry.
Isn't it funny though?
And it's it is.
Do you mind if I just put a children's tape on to listen to as an adult?
And for
a
while, maybe I'll be polite and be like, I'll sleep with my headphones in. But they fall out, and like, so after a while, I'm like, this is who I am. I listen to Stephen Fry every night. Yes, there are only seven books, and I will listen 1 to 7 and then back 1 to 7 and then go 1 to 7
because
again.
Because it's like calming.
It is.
And actually, the person I'm listening with hasn't listened to them, so they're actually very excited by it.
Wow, they must not
be sleeping at
all.
They're like, who's Tom Riddle? It's like, what?
Wow, I wish that actually every time I finished 7, I could erase my memory.
Yeah.
Right? A confundus charm.
Oh my God.
And just to go back to 1 and listen to it like it was the very first time, honestly.
What is your guilty pleasure song for singing over and over in the shower? Can be one of yours or can be someone else's.
Call Me Maybe.
Hey, I just
met you. Mm.
This is crazy. Let's get our number.
So what?
Call Me Maybe.
Yeah. It's a great song.
Out of nowhere.
No, it's actually
bamboozling me.
It's such a good song. I never got why people like.
No, it's a banger.
Thought it was funny. It's actually like a really really good song.
Carly Rae Jepsen.
Yeah. Shout outs to you.
Shout out to you. Also, kind of a song that you could sing, like a bit like Good Luck, in the club to, like, you know.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Get in a vibe.
In a vibe.
Also, actually, it's a bit, Good Luck's a bit more for your ex, but Call Me Maybe to your crush in their face.
Right, so it's like you do Good Luck when you're getting ready and then you listen to Call Me Maybe when you're in the club and you're like, hey, babe. Call me.
Hey, babe, call me. But also, am I joking? I'm not sure.
But I just love the phrasing of that. It's like, call me. Maybe.
Maybe. But
it's very me if I was hitting on somebody.
Oh, really?
Because I'm like, I'm so awkward. So I'd be like, yeah, you know, call, like, here's my number. Call me. Maybe. I don't know.
I'm more like,
if you feel like it.
Call me or I'll cry.
Okay, that's really intense.
And sad. That's why, mostly all of the time single. What is a weird snack or food habit that you do at home that you really shouldn't? But you love it. So
pickles.
You don't stop.
Just pickles, straight pickles.
Why are we the same person? It's freaking me out now. Carry on. Pickles. Tell me what kind of pickles you like.
I like Swedish pickles.
Ooh.
They're a little bit sweeter. Gurka. It's
gurka.
Really good. Gurka.
Oof.
Really good. Yeah.
Do you like gherkins?
Love gherkins.
Yeah.
New green. Mm. Love a new green.
Specific as well.
I have pickles on my rider. So everywhere that everywhere we go, I get pickles. And have to say, and
Mabel's
I don't,
just in the corner crunching.
I just eat them straight out of the jar. It really freaks my boyfriend out. Like he cannot, like it just, it creeps people out. Some people are like really weird about pickles. Like they are like almost phobic of the way that they look.
Weird.
Really weird, super strange. Don't know why you would be a hater. Pickles are great. And there's so many different types. Like people don't know, like the Swedish ones are sweet, but then like new greens, you have them, they're salty. You know, there's nuances, but traveling and getting pickles from every different place around the world is a vibe. And I have to say that Germany, pickles, they got it down.
Germany's got the best pickles.
Yeah.
I do feel like the next line of merch should be just you releasing some pickles.
Just.
Release the pickles!
Release the pickles! Yeah, I love pickles.
Oh, wow. I'm just overwhelmed by how brilliant this is. Who is your weird celebrity crush? Someone who other people don't fancy, but they're a bit of you.
Oh, I'm so basic with my...
crushes.
But, oh, no, I know.
Okay.
The Joker.
Which one?
Just all Jokers. Like, even...
Anyone who's played
even
Joker.
Joaquin Phoenix when he was, like,
really?
Skinny and weird and, like, not a vibe.
Let's
I was like,
talk that one through.
I just think the Joker is misunderstood and super, super sexy. In all forms. Heath Ledger, Jack Nicholson, Joaquin. Like, I'll take them all.
Wow.
Jed. Let's not forget Jed. He was a sexy Joker. Yeah.
She likes a clown.
I do. But he's misunderstood, and I always said this, even before the movie The Joker came out, I was like, no, he is misunderstood. He just wants to be loved, and I can be that person. I can change him. I can fix him.
You fight for your bae.
I will, yeah.
Wow. I can't wait for who gets announced as the next Joker.
Babe, honestly, I just want to be Harley. That's why I want to be Harley
Quinn. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
You'd make a great Harley.
I'd just want to be Harlequin and
make
just
it happen.
And have Joker Bay.
Margot, stand aside.
Literally, sexiest woman in the world. What? Who cares? Who cares?
Right, final one.
Okay.
First dates. Forget food, drinks and dinner and stuff, fancy stuff. What would be your ideal date that you're sorry not sorry for? Like something...
I know.
Oh, you know, there she is.
A dance class. Salsa dancing. Something, a tango class. Give me some kind of like, do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that would be most men's nightmare. Nightmare. But I would love it. I just want to see you, I want to know how you handle an awkward situation. You, me, and a dance teacher, we're going to wear the clothes. We're going to, and I want to know, can you laugh at yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Can you find this? Can you find the funny in this? But also take it semi-seriously so that we can, you know, post a tango TikTok when we're done.
Yeah, because you want to get something out of it.
Obviously.
Obviously.
Because most dates, let's face it, are trash. First dates. Terrible, awkward, horrible.
So uncomfortable.
Them. So uncomfortable. Like, I'm like, didn't even know I could sweat from some of the places that I'm sweating from.
Yeah.
Why did I just mention my dead grandmother?
Oh, without
like,
a doubt.
Yeah, just so awkward. Like, no, but I just think add a dance class into that. A rose, the tango rose,
ooh,
the tight
yeah.
trousers, maybe some frill, you
know. Oh, some definite frilling.
Yeah,
and without a doubt.
Can you find this funny?
Yeah, you need, well, that, I think that's a very good test for anything.
Yeah.
Put someone in a really uncomfortable situation and see how they squirm.
I also just like introduce people to my family straight away.
Yeah.
That's my thing, because I'm just like, I'm a very much a package deal. and I have a big, very loud, very inappropriate, like crazy family. So if you can just come in there.
If you can handle that,
yeah,
then you can handle anything.
Because it's like, I don't want to do 10 dates and then you meet my family and then be like, yeah, no, he's trash.
Yeah, because that's the denominator, is that a word? I don't know. The thing that decides whether you know someone's legit is if they pass the test of meeting your weird family, because I'm the same.
Yeah, no, so it's like dance class, straight to mum's house.
So anyone looking for Mabel to be their girlfriend, you know what you're in for.
Exactly.
Dance class and then meet the mum. Lovely. Mabel, thank you so much for playing Sorry Not Sorry.
Thank you.
You aced the test.
Thanks.
Nailed it.
Turns out I'm really weird.
Turns out you're really great and
weird.
Thanks. Thank you.